today we're going to look at personal worship and corporate worship. Worship is also an offering of sacrifice to God. And in the book of Leviticus, we read some more about how these sacrifices should be offered, how it should be done in a certain way. Great detail, right? So let's look at the tabernacle. The tabernacle itself, you know, it's a big tent, and this is how it is. We see the altar of burnt offerings. We see the bronze laver. That's in what is called the outer court. Then we move into the next section, which has the table of showbread, lampstand, altar for burning incense, and then the Holy of Holies. It's interesting to see that in the book of Hebrews, it says that all this was symbolic. All this was symbolic. Symbolic of the present times. The sacrifice itself, symbolic of that perfect sacrifice, of that blood which would be shed, talking about the Lord Jesus. Let us draw near in worship. Some things that we can do as we draw near to God, and being aware of what He has done for us on the cross, no matter what, you know, we're going through, draw near to Him and express thanksgiving. Give thanks to Him. Psalm 36, it's scripted here, verse 5. Your mercy, O Lord, is in the heavens. Your faithfulness reaches to the clouds. Your righteousness is like great mountains. So use that as a script. Open the word and say, O God, your mercy, it extends to the heavens. I draw near to you and I draw near with a grateful heart. I give thanks to you. I give thanks to you that I can see this, that I can read this. And you, O God, your mercy, it is in the heavens. Pray, we can speak and sing in tongues. Sing out in, I've run out of words, God. You know, the psalmist says, oh, for 1,000 tongues to sing my Redeemer's praise. Now, praise involves sacrifice. There is a cost. You know, sacrifice is giving up something that you have a right to, or taking on something that you don't have to. Sacrifice. Sacrifice also means death to certain things. Halal, which means to rave about, to boast about, to be excited about. Psalm 22 says, verse 22, I will declare your name to my brethren. In the midst of the assembly, I will praise you. The word used there is halal. In the midst of the assembly, I will praise you. Verse 23, all who fear the Lord, praise Him. All you descendants of Jacob, glorify Him and fear Him, all you offspring of Israel. So what is David saying here? I will praise you. In the assembly, I will rave about you, I will boast about you, I will be foolish, I will do certain things excitedly, I will do it in the assembly. Proclamation or spoken words. It is not just singing, but us speaking. And we can use scriptures to do this. Psalm 26 and verse 7 says, that I may proclaim Him with the voice of thanksgiving and tell of all your wondrous works. Then, of course, the most common one that we know is singing. Psalm 47 and verse 6 says, sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our King, sing praises. So what happens when we praise God? When we praise God, He is enthroned in our praise. So when we come together as a church and with our in spirit, in truth, we come and offer this sacrifice of praise to Him. And when He receives it, we experience the presence of God. Some attitudes, you know, really hinder pride, right? Hey, I'm too dignified for this. Then you look at David, oh, the king, ruler of a nation, dancing unashamedly before God. So pride, irreverence at times, you know, when we don't come before Him with respect and honor, that's a hindrance. Another attitude could be, spectatorism. We come before Him and I just want to, you know, just watch what is happening. I'm a spectator. I want to hear the singing. Maybe sentimentalism, oh, this song, you know, we used to do this over in those days. Those were the good old days. And we are getting very nostalgic about the song. We're getting very sentimental about the song. But we've lost our focus of the truth that the song is actually about. Matthew 15 and verse 8, the Lord says, you know, these people draw near to me with their lips, but their heart is far away. He says, they're drawing near, but their heart is far away. So we are called to engage in spirit and in truth. Right? Whether we are alone or whether we are together. So let's not trade one for the other, saying, I do it at home, or, you know, I do it only in church. Let's draw near because we are priests unto God.